Hey there, Luke here. I just wanted to go over a question one of my athletes had with me the other day. With my athletes, especially during marathon training, I really push for them to practice their fueling, especially during long runs and marathon pace workouts, where they're really approaching the volume of intake that they want to get to during the race, right? And so there's a number of reasons, obviously, the practice of doing that, being very comfortable with doing that on race day, knowing what's going to work at race pace, and knowing what's going to settle in your stomach okay over a long period of time. So there's a lot of reasons why we do that. But she had the question of whether or not she should do that for other workouts. So if you follow our workouts at all, we do stuff like speed training and what we call strength workouts during marathon training. And so, and it's not the strength like lifting weights, it's strength as far as building specific endurance right around lactate threshold, a little bit slower than lactate threshold. So they're a little bit shorter, but they're still fairly long workouts. And so her question was whether or not she should still do that as far as taking in fuel and fluids. And the short answer is yes, I think you should. Maybe not for the exact reasons we do for the marathon pace workouts and the long runs, but I do think it's very important. A lot of times there's a short window of turnaround between doing, say, a speed workout and then a marathon pace workout, right? So if you follow traditional Hansen's marathon method, it'd be Tuesday speed or strength, Wednesday off, Thursday tempo run, and then you go Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday long run. So if you're going from Tuesday to Thursday, a very short window of time to recover those glycogen stores. So while it might not make or break that workout in particular, it's going to help speed along recovery by helping get in the glucose and helping you get through the workout, but then it's also going to trigger getting into those glycogen storage. Right? So if you can not go into a big glycogen deficit by supplying carbohydrate during the workout, you're going to shorten that recovery time, which is very important. And I think too, I see with a lot of athletes is that over time, they just don't get enough carbohydrate in on a daily basis. So by doing, even if it doesn't have to be to the extent of what you're doing for marathon pace. So if you're trying to get 60 grams an hour during your tempo runs, it doesn't necessarily have to be 60 grams an hour. It could be, you know, 25 to 30, say a gel an hour of workout, right? And if you supplement that with a little bit of pre-workout, like with a sports drink and you have some carbohydrate in there, a gel during the workout, and then you recover with the protein and carbohydrates that you should in that window of opportunity that you maximize that, you can go a long way with shortening that recovery time. And so if you don't do that, you will still recover, but it might not be as long. And over time, I feel like what will happen is those tempo runs will get harder and harder to be ready for. And so I think it is important to do that. And it might not be necessarily a short-term thing. It might not be just to get through that workout in particular, but over time, I think what it's going to do is help you maintain that level of carbohydrate, recover faster before your next workout. And then ultimately those workouts will go better. And then you'll ultimately have more confidence and you'll feel better at race pace and you'll go through the segment a lot smoother than if you're constantly gradually digging a hole every week. So so the short answer is I do think you should, and hopefully my explanation of why will help you make that decision. So that's it for now, but that's just one simple thing where, like, if the training can go great, except for the detail work. And so I would consider this a detail, part of the detail, supplemental type of work that is ultimately going to make you a better runner, make you more consistent, and make you better at workouts over time, because you're just going to be recovered better and be able to handle the workload a lot better over weeks and months at a time. So hopefully that helps. I will talk to you later. See ya.